Session 10, we're going to discuss postnatal care. And there is so much to be discussed on the postnatal care. So we'll be doing postnatal care 1 and postnatal care 2. Postnatal care is a planned care given to the mother and the baby by the midwife within 6 weeks after delivery. The activities include care, support, monitoring the health of the mother and baby. It incorporates both the physical and emotional well-being of the new mother, taking into consideration the individuality of each client's ability to adapt to the postnatal period. Now, different women adapt to the postnatal period differently. Some become joyous right after delivery and they carry it on. Others may become depressed or have mixed emotions, and they should be handled differently. Now, in our definition, we said that it's a planned care. It means that we don't just carry out routine postnatal care. If you did focused antenatal, then you should do a focused postnatal care. So if you knew the woman's challenges during pregnancy, then postpartum, you should have a planned care for this woman. Like I said, it may differ from woman to woman. By the end of this session, I expect that you should be able to provide support for the new mother and baby, assess mother for the need for further care during this period. Now, as they come for the postnatal screening, you are also watching out for any abnormalities. And if you realize that there are any things that need intervention, you identify it early before it becomes very serious. The key topics to be covered in this session are as follows. We want to do the definitions. We want to manage the mother. We want to look at the aim of management. We also want to be able to manage the baby. And this is our major reading list. How do we define postnatal care? I think I tried to define postnatal care when we were discussing the session overview. And like I said, it's a planned type of care. You plan the care. And during this period, the activity of the midwife is to support the mother and find out any physiological or emotional changes that has taken place since she delivered. The postnatal care extends throughout the period and is directed to achieve the following: to ensure that postnatal care is related to the needs of each individual, like I explained earlier on, promoting conducive environment in which the mother can be certain of adequate rest and free from unwanted stress. To identify postnatal problems in the physical or emotional well-being, you ensure good communication between all the people providing care to the mother. In our focus antenatal, you should have started this already, and then you continue. You provide an opportunity for learning and discussion, thereby building the confidence of the woman and her family. We want to look at the physiological and physical assessment of the mother. Now, during the postnatal period, this woman is assessed thoroughly, just like when she was assessed during pregnancy. And you take particular notes of the mother's complaints and feelings. If she says she feels unduly tired, it suggests that the mother may be having anemia or infection. Now, if you want to examine this woman during the postnatal period, you want to start from the head of the woman to the toe of the woman. For the head, we want to look at the hair. Is it brittle? Does it denote malnutrition? Do we have lice and nits in the hair? Is the woman's hair unkempt? And you educate the woman accordingly. You also inspect the woman's eyes for jaundice. Has she got any sunken eyes? It tells you that she's having dehydration, anemia, or any other condition. Are you having any pallor? The mouth, you check for halitosis. You also check for paleness. And the neck, you examine the lymph nodes or the enlarged thyroid gland, or if there's any enlarged thyroid gland. You inspect the skin for any rashes, any dehydration. If you pinch the skin and it's dehydrated, you will see by how the pinch returns to normal. And then you observe for striae. The breast is inspected for engorgement, sore, cracked nipples. You see, have any mastitis, and then you educate on exclusive breastfeeding, which you started earlier on. You reinforce it. And the abdomen, you check for involution. So depending on the time she comes for the postnatal care, you do a measurement of the fundus. 1 to 3 days, it should be 3 centimeters below the umbilicus, and it continues to decrease at the rate of 1 centimeter daily. By day 4 to 9, the fundus is palpable above the symphysis pubis. In the 5th to 6th weeks, the fundus is not palpable above the symphysis pubis. So you're examining the fundus and you have this physiology in mind. You come to the perineum, the pelvic floor assessment. You ensure that the perineum, vagina, vulva, and bowel have recovered from trauma. Episiotomy is also inspected to ascertain whether the incision is healing well with no sign of infection. You also look at the elimination pattern of the woman. Is she urinating well? Is she having any incontinence? There could be trauma during the time of delivery to the bladder or the urethra, and this may lead to incontinence. So you have to find out from the woman. You also do a urine analysis to check for any sugar or protein in the urine, and then you do some check for bowel movement. And sometimes initially after delivery, the bowel movement may be uncomfortable, but it should be able to return to its pre-gavid state. You continue with lochia. We have explained lochia already, and we are saying it undergoes sequential changes as involution progresses. Day 1 to 3, the lochia is going to be red, and we refer to it as lochia rubra, and it is common to have clots within this lochia. From day 5 to 9, the lochia becomes pink, and we refer to it as lochia serosa. If there is any foul smell, it suggests infection. Day 10 to 14, the lochia goes back. The lochia changes color now to white, and then we refer to it as lochia alba. And the discharge is paler and contains leukocytes. From the 5th to 6th weeks, there may be recurrence of ovulation and menstruation, and you have to find out this information from the woman. You examine the lower extremities of the woman for edema, for varicose veins, or thrombophlebitis. Especially for thrombophlebitis, if the woman is complaining of severe pain, especially in the calf muscles, then you should be ruling out thrombophlebitis, which is a serious complication of the puerperium. The vital signs is also done. You measure the temperature, the pulse, and the respiration, and then you want to find out if there is any abnormality. If the woman was normotensive or had no hypertension, but then the blood pressure has gone up around this time, then we should call for help. Respiration is monitored to exclude breathing disorders like dyspnea. We should have about 16 to 20 breaths per minute. The temperature should be checked to exclude any infection. Hemoglobin level assessment is done to detect any anemia. Now you want to do a psychological assessment. This is sometimes missing in our postnatal assessments. So our women had depression and will miss it till they start manifesting or throwing away their babies. Psychological assessment is very important during the postnatal period. The transition to parenthood is often difficult and may be perceived as crisis, especially by primates or very young mothers. During this transition, both parents, especially the mother, adjust her pattern of living to meet the needs of the infant. The midwife counsels the mother on her new role, allays her fears and anxieties, and uplifts the mother's self-esteem. The foundation of the relationship between the infant and his parents is laid. The maternal-child relationship begins during pregnancy as the mother becomes aware of the fetal movement and activity. This relationship develops rapidly following the birth of the baby. Paternal involvement is also encouraged. Psychosocial adaptation of the mother. Psychosocial adaptation. This mother has had changes in her body. He has had changes in the function of her body. And sometimes some get so disappointed by the change they experience in their bodies after delivery. And this affects the maternal role attainment. And that is why we say that that role should begin long before the actual birth comes in. So that right from pregnancy, this woman has been prepared that these are the changes you are going to experience. For instance, those who have fair skin may become dark, and it will take a very long time for them to regain their color tone. And the mother must be aware of all this, so they don't become depressed after delivery due to their new look, and then it affects their maternal role attainment. So you educate the mother on the new task ahead, that you'll be forfeiting some sleep. You have to be waking up. If you were waking up at 7 o'clock now, you may have to wake up at 4, try to put some things together before baby wakes up. So you teach the mother how to adapt to the new role. Like I said, this should have started during our focus antenatal. The mother also learns to balance multiple roles and relationship with others. She is a worker, she is a wife, she's now become a mother, she's also somebody else's daughter, and all that. And she should be able to balance all those multiple roles. If not, she'll have psychological crisis. Socioeconomic assessment. The socioeconomic status of the family affects care. And then it's also used to determine the resources available to the family and also helps the nurse in her health education. So you have to do socioeconomic assessment. Now, when they come and are taking their history, if it's not just to fill in the blank spaces, we want to find out what do you do, what does your husband do, but more often we just fill in and we don't link it to the care. We are saying that if this woman is not working or she is a petty trader, now that she's delivered and she is home, can somebody continue with her trading? Will she have to hold on till she goes back? How is she going to sustain herself financially? And then, what is the husband's occupation? Are there any supports she can get from church or from any other group? You should be able to assess this woman and then link her up appropriately. Now, I want to look at health education. During the postnatal period, there is a need for you to do health education, and it's very crucial to the postnatal mothers. It's educated on the following: infection prevention, rest and sleep, breastfeeding of the baby, good nutrition, sexual activity, and immunization. So depending on any other challenge the woman has, she is also educated as such. She is also educated on the danger signs to expect, because if she goes home and she's experiencing any danger sign, she should be able to report immediately. In summary, postnatal period is the time when the mother is assessed to determine her adaptation to her new role. It's also a period where mother is further educated on the care of the baby. The mother and baby are both examined periodically to the progression of postpartum phase and to identify any deviations and for appropriate referral. These are references, and this brings us to the end of the session.